guys and ladies, it is Corné. Today is the 13th of November 2017. I want to share the setup which I spot on two pairs. And on those two pairs, three trades, and I make 85 pips on it. The first one was on the Euro Aussie. This is a daily chart. Now on the daily, first I want to show you guys the trend is up. There's a high, the highs are getting higher, the lows also getting higher, so it indicates this price is going up. But the price did retrace from that level till almost at the lower band, rolling band. But what I want to show you guys is, on this retracement, we have a higher high. There's a bull bars, I close there, as I close there, that price is higher than that high. So it's indication that price will go up again. Then I notice, as the market opened this morning for the new week, this price retraced back almost till this swing high here, which is now resistance. So I say this is very interesting. If we can get a nice setup happening from here, we might see a very nice run on the upward side. So I was looking at the 4 hour and see if I can spot a reason to look to enter. Now on the 4 hour, let me go there. Alright, on the 4 hour, what I saw was this bar. You see, that swing I'm talking about was here. This 4 hour went up, leaving this pin behind. I thought it's going to close bullish engulfing. I watch it. And then I said, well, I'm not going to enter blindly, knowing that there's a nice resistance on a 1 hour, on the daily. So I will look for reason here to enter. So basically what I do is, I just go to a lower time frame as a new bar open. Usually I go to the 5 minutes, but today it was very noisy. Now, if what do I mean it's noisy? Is you get, looks like a setup. Once you enter, after a while, it looks like it's fine. Then you get out again. Every time you enter and get out, it costs money, and you don't want to see that. So what I did is, I'm looking at a higher time frame, the 15 minute here. It's less noisy. Now let me show you. Going to the 15 minute thing. Okay, if you go to 15 minute, you can see here, price retrace back. So if price retrace back, I'm looking for two higher highs. I want to see there's a high, and then I want to see a higher bear bar, and then I want to see a higher bull bar again. There's a high, a higher high, a low, a lower, a higher low. So this is what I'm looking for. So at this area here, we will enter. Now let me show you on a 4 hour where that enter was. On the 4 hour, it happened, on the 4 hour, it happened at this line here. Alright. Now, and I was saying, where would I take profit? Let me show you guys what I did. I say, well, I'm gonna take profit. If you look left, you see market went up. Then it came at this area, it hesitated, it went up again. It came back here, it breaks that area, and this line came and expected. Tell me this is a very nice area of resistance. So I said, if price came at this area, I will take profit. So let's look at it. So we enter at this level, we take profit at that level, 35 pips. Very simple and easy. Alright, then I say, well, I know what I know at the 1 day, the price might go higher. We're going to do the same. I'm going to look if price retrace. We don't know if price will continue or if it will come down. So what I do is I go to the 15 minute again. Go on the 15 minute chart again. Okay, I'm going to take all this. And for a call, we're looking for two higher bull bars and one higher bear bar. Now look at this. Price retrace back, nothing. And then we have this bull bar close. It's higher than this structure. We have those dojis, bear bar close for me. It's higher than this bear bar. And then we have a bull bar close higher. That's a confirmation. So what I do is, on that level, I'm going to put the line there. Because this profit I just take now. Just took it. Alright. Now let's look, where would be a nice price show why I did get down there. I was looking at, if you look left, you see there's a swing there. I was thinking about this area here, but this yellow line is a round number. It is 5300. And the market just sitting here is doing nothing. And then I look at how does a price react on the 1 hour. And on the 1 hour, this is what I see. You see, price went next to the building band, then it go away. Every time it go away is weakness. It hit the building band and the next bar go away again. Now tell me there's some weakness happening here. And it's not even a strong bar. Look how small is it. It's like they decided the price will stick at the 5300. So I decide that's it. I take profit there at that yellow line. So basically I enter here. I take profit about the 25 pips. So it's 35 and 25 on that setup, and I'm out there. Okay, this was a setup because now I'm in the Asian market. The Asian market price like more to consolidate. You know, you don't always get this run on the Asian market. Most of the time it's consolidating. So that's why I decided to get out there. Now let me show you the other setup. It happened on the Euro New Zealand. Let's go to the daily. On the daily, the same story. Let me first take away all these yellow lines. That is round numbers. Right, that's on the daily. Now on the daily again, price retrace back, then the next Friday this price goes higher than this swing here, and so it's indication price want to go up. So what I did is I spot this price retrace back. You see that, what week there? It was bear bar. When it was there, it was a bear bar at this week. And I said, well, if I can get the setup on the 4 hour, tell me this thing want to go up, price might go continue, who knows where. So I go to 4 hour. So on the 4 hour, this bar, you see price came here, we have like a swing here, and then suddenly on this swing, the next bar, I know a daily resistance hit it, it looks bullish. So I say, well, now I want to see if I can get a setup on the 15 minute. I'm gonna enter, and let's do that. Go, just gonna mark that area. So I just want to see if we can get two bull bars, two higher bull bars and one higher high. It's indication price want to go up. You can do it on the 15 minute, but the 15 minute is very very busy. Okay, let's look at it. Look at the price came down, nothing here, went up. So that's the bull bars going higher. We have a bear bar, and the next one is a bull bar going higher. So I say at this level, I want to enter. Now let's look at the 4 hour where's that point. Very simple. On the 4 hour, we enter here. I say where I would like to take profit. Look, let's look where can I take profit. I can take profit. I was looking at this pin here. So from that area, about 35 pips. Price didn't do much because so that's 35 pips. Then I look again to enter here. I did enter, but I almost get out with a little profit. I'll show you. Let me rather do that because we're in the Asian market. I don't think this price will go much higher. You see the price, look at the next bar just open there. If I go to a 15 minute, let me take this, you know which way is the area. Look here, price went up. We have this bear bar is higher than that bar. We have a bullish close higher than that one. Add that purple one, you enter. You enter. enter the and price, you can see, look at this red line, that is resistance for our daily name. It there is a huge resistance in this line, and the price is just sitting there. And I don't make a lot, I enter more or less. Maybe it's going to break through now, but I'm out. Enter more or less, that's about 10 pips. I think I make about 5 pips there. Okay, guys, and that's it. This is the setups, these two setups. There was no W of M patterns today, only I trade the breakout with a retracement, looking at the 15 minute on a call, two higher bull bars, one higher bear bar, setup, and that's it. Boom. Okay, I hope you enjoy it and learn something out of it. So, rather look at the 15 minute for a pullback, it's less noise. The 5 minute, many noise, meaning we can get false signals on the 5 minute. Thank you. We have a Skype group. If you like to enter the Skype group, as we take the trades, we alert each other. You can